Hi, and welcome back to the Blue Screen Brothers. Today, I still have Marius with me. And Marius, we were thinking about something step-by-step.
Yes, we're going to make some quick like step-by-step guides for certain tasks that we... That's just common tasks, right? So, yeah. Sure, you can follow some documentation or you can just click along what we do.
Yeah.
So, today we're going to be working with a Microsoft Graph from PowerShell. And more specifically, we're going to use an app registration and then also a service principle to do that. So, we're going to show how from scratch, essentially.
Yeah, so this is a step-by-step series of guides added to our app registration deep dive series of videos.
Yes, that is correct. So you we won't go into details on, for example, the permissions and stuff. See our other videos for that. So the first step that we need to do is to go into the Azure portal and find Entra ID, or you can go to entra.microsoft.com. That's up to you what you prefer, but I would expect the Entra portal to become the primary after a while at least, but not as of the recording. But we go to app registrations and we create a new app. Let's call it PowerShell 123. And since we are doing a non-interactive sign-in as a as an app, we don't need any redirect URIs or anything. Also, we can do this in a multi-tenant way, where if we want to work with the graph in a different tenant, that is possible here. We simply need to change the tenant ID, but we will use a single tenant in this video. You can see our other videos for understanding the difference. So what we need to do first is that we need to assign some permissions. We can do this by going to API permissions and add a permission. We are going to work with the Microsoft Graph, but we can easily work with the other services as well. We are going to add an application permission. Let's simply do a user read write all. So this will give us access to read and write all users. Of course, not users that are locked by Azure AD Connect because they are synced from on-prem AD. We're going to add permission. Right now, our app doesn't have any permissions because we still haven't done the admin consent. So we're going to click grant admin consent, which will actually assign this permission to the Microsoft Graph for our app. So now our API, no, our app registration is ready and we need a secret. So we need a way to identify ourselves to enter ID. So let's just create a secret like this. So now we have everything and this value will disappear when you close or navigate away from the app registration. So make sure that you keep it someplace safe. Now, let us create a script that uses all of this or this app registration to get the access token. So what we're going to try is to use Copilot. So let's just say start code chat and ask for something like, create a PowerShell script that takes client ID, client secret, and tenant ID as input and gets an access token for Microsoft Graph. Let's see how decent Copilot has become. Let's accept this. This looks quite good. So I can see that we did of course create this beforehand as well, and now it's actually even more secure because we will see something about secure string here, and I can mention that a little bit, so I don't need to save it. let's just run it for now. I'm going to run these defined variables first. So enter the client ID. We can find that on the overview page. And this client ID. And paste. Okay. Enter the client secret. It should still be here. Like this. And our tenant ID. This one. So as we will see here, this is now a secure string. So it actually has to convert the secure string into plain text before sending it to Entra ID, because this is a simple client credential grant. We have a standard URL for reaching our tenant. This will vary depending on the environment that you're connecting to. So this is the regular public Microsoft Cloud. But if you're on like US government plan or anything, then this login microsoftonline.com will be different. We build a body where essentially the client ID, the scope, you see this dot default will give you all the configured permissions. We add our client secret, and now we're ready to send it to Entra ID. Well, it did something wrong.
Yeah.
And what is wrong is that I didn't run this line, so that is wrong.
Yeah.
So here we got the response, which you will see has the access token. It also has a expires in value, and this will essentially always say this value. And this content is also encoded into the access token. You can actually take this and split it and do some tricks to decode if you really want to check for expiry, if you're running a long-running task, for example. So you can see here is our access token, and let's see if we can use it as well. Let's call the Microsoft Graph user endpoint for getting all users like this. Let's see if Copilot wants to help me. Invoke-RestMethode URI HTTPS graph Microsoft.com. And here I can do whatever, right? Any call that I have permission to call with my access token. Headers, authorization. I need to send my token as a bearer token, like this. And I got a response. So what you will see now is that I built this authorization header, sending it, and this is just a regular way of sending the access token as a bearer token. So there's a space between here, and then comes the token, essentially. Perfectly normal. And this is my user's endpoint. And of course, I can post users because I have user read write all. But we can also verify that if I were to call groups, then no, I don't have access to that.
Yeah, that was because we only give the permission on the reader, read write all on the user, not the group.
That is correct.
Yeah.
Yes. So that was the very manual way. We can also use the SDK for doing the same thing. So first of all, if you use the Microsoft Graph module, you have this Microsoft.graph authentication submodule, which is the only requirement that you need. And what you can, of course, do is this. Just connect MgGraph, provide a scope that you want, and run it. Now, I was already signed in, so let's disconnect in order to actually show it, like this. But the problem is that now I sign in with a user, and this is very interactive. So this does indeed work, but now I'm a user signed in, which I didn't really want. So instead, what I can do is that I have already asked Copilot to do this as well. that it's fairly simple. We need our client ID, secret, and tenant ID as input. those we actually already have, though our client secret is not a plain text value anymore. So from our example. So we can now create a credential. So PSCredential is often used to call different methods, and it's more secure just to sort of enforce that you need to send, for example, the client secret to a method in a secure way rather than doing like I do here with a plain text value. What we can now do is that we will call Connect-MgGraph again, and it works just as before. As you can see, client ID is the username, client secret is the password of this PS credential. I can actually do get network credential on this one and type username. As you can see, that's my client ID and password, which is my client secret. And I provide a tenant ID. And now we should be able to call Invoke-MgGraphRequest, which will send a very raw request that I can define everything on, or I can simply do get MG graph user. Or I cannot do that. MG graph. Why?
Yeah.
I know why. Because I only loaded the authentication part on my module.
Yeah, not the use
part. So in order to speed up your scripts, because you see here that now this takes forever to load, because it loads a gazillion different submodules. I believe it's something like 70 or 80 submodules in PowerShell. And using my first example, I only loaded graph.authentication, and that is to speed up things a lot.
Yeah.
And as you can see, I'm still loading.
Yeah.
So
I think it's about 700-800 megabytes in just installations, files, all the modules and all the stuff, if I remember correctly.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. So it can definitely take a while, which is why I often just load what I need, because the Microsoft graph is huge. So this MG graph request is included in the base requirement for everything. So this will always work. But if you want the more easy to use get MG graph user, get MG graph group, and so on, you can load the required modules, and you can find that on the PowerShell gallery.
Yeah.
So now we have a working method of using a app registration and service principle to connect to the Microsoft Graph.
Yeah. You say awesome. So, but we haven't seen any proof yet.
No, there we did it here. These are our users. So we're still waiting for my computer to load the Microsoft Graph, apparently. So let's call that a wrap and see you in the
next
episode.
And the script will be available if you want to see all the scripts later. Instead of trying to write them down from the screen, you can actually download them from the link we will provide.
GitHub in the description. Yeah.
Perfect. Well, see you at the next step-by-step guide then.
See you.